Hello there, it's Sarah from Paper Lovely. Thanks for joining me today. Before we get started, I want to give a big congratulations to Wendy Thompson. Wendy, you are the winner of my sticker sheet giveaway from the last card kit video that I did. You'll find my email address in the contact info below. Please send me an email with your address and I will get your stickers out in the mail to you. So I'm again today working with an Imagine That paper pack from Echo Park. This is the boy version, and I'm giving you a quick look at what was included, a bunch of 12 by 12 papers, some cut aparts, as well as a 12 by 12 sticker sheet. So the first thing I did with this kit was the cut aparts, and there were some that were 4x4. I trimmed those down to 4x3 as best as I could, just to make it a little bit easier. Those larger cut aparts there, I trimmed to as close to 4x5 1/4 as I could, and I'll place those directly on top of a white card base. From there, I took the 12x12 papers and trimmed them to 6x6, and then down to 4x5 1/4, which left me with strips that measured 2x6 and 4x3/4 inch. I also then had a few leftovers. These were cut aparts that didn't really have anything on them that I thought would work for cards for hospitalized kids, so I'll just use the backs of those wherever I can. I'm again using sentiment strips as well as sentiment circles. I use the Tailored Expressions Come On Get Happy stamp set and went with the sentiment Sending You a Smile. I also have some 3 and 3.5 inch circles that I will use on the card fronts. So I'm going to take all of those cut aparts, and here I'm just matching them up by the background colors, and then I'll go through and pick out some coordinating background panels to go with them. To get myself into the swing of things, I'm going to start off fairly simple. I'm taking a background panel and I'll add in a coordinating strip of the 2x6 inch pattern paper. I'll place that across the middle and then I will add the cut apart on top of that. From there, I will pull out the different leftover background papers and stripes, and I'll use the sticker sheet to create the additional cards. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and turn up the music so you can enjoy the process. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below, and I will be back at the end to finish everything up.
Thank you.
So at this point, I had used all of my larger scraps, but I still had quite a few of the smaller strips left, as well as quite a few of the stickers. So I thought I would create some backgrounds using those. Here I've got a Nina panel trimmed to 4x5 1/4, and I'm just laying some ATG gun across that and then layering these stripes on top. I had quite a few of these left. I think I was able to make about 5 panels like this. And then I also had some 2x2 inch squares left over from when I trimmed off the excess of the stripes on those first cut apart cards. So as soon as I finish with these striped panels, I will make sort of a checkerboard panel using the same process of adding ATG gun on the top of a Nina panel and then just trimming off the excess. Thank you. So as you can see there, I'm just going through and trying to use up what I have left of the stickers. There are some that just aren't gonna work. They're meant more for scrapbooking rather than for cards. So I do have a few that are left over, but I was able to use the majority of them. And then when it came to the paper, I was left with just one 2x2-inch square. So I was able to make a total of 54 cards using this paper pack, which is a record for me. This is going to complete the video for today. You'll find photos as well as a full list of supplies at my blog post linked in the description below. If you enjoyed the video, please leave me a comment or a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.